Hello viewers, today let's try some South Indian appams without any yeast or soda. We just need 3 ingredients: raw rice, grated fresh coconut and cooked rice. The proportions are as given. So first we soak the rice. I wash it well and soak it. And then after 4 hours, you take a little bit of the rice, very little, and grind it fine with little water. Grind it to a fine paste and then put it in a pan. Heat it along with some water so that it forms a paste in medium flame. Then you take the same grinder, add the remaining rice, coconut and cooked rice, and add this paste little by little. If you can grind all of them together, fine. Or you can just grind them in batches. So again, grind them to a very fine paste and keep it aside. Now again, talking about the paste, it is just a very simple thing. You just take a little, even 2 tablespoons of rice, grind it fine with little water, heat it in the pan with a slow flame so that it forms a paste, and then add it when you're grinding the other ingredients. So when you do this, you don't need any yeast or soda. Also, when you cut coconut for using, you can even store the water of coconut. You can either store it in the fridge, maybe you can just store it for 24 hours, and you can use a little bit of that too while grinding. It is optional. Otherwise, you can use plain water. So once you're done with the grinding, you mix the batter thoroughly. Don't add salt at this point. Just mix the batter and cover and keep it for say 8 to 10 hours or overnight. So I have kept it overnight. The next morning, you can see it has formed a frothy batter. It's fermented a bit. You can see some bubbles. You can adjust the water and add the salt at this point. Mix well. Now take an iron pan. Pan is a deep fry pan, or you can even take a non-stick one if you have. Grease it well. You can grease a non-stick pan too. And then add the batter, say 2 spoons. And with both the handles, try to spread the batter in such a way that the appam is thicker in the center and thinner on the sides, which will make it crispier. So the center is soft and it turns spongy later, and the sides have to be thin. So, and then cover and cook it. See again the same repeat of how we add the batter, say 2 spoons, and then you turn the pan this way. Now once you open the lid, see that the sides leave from the pan. Don't try to remove it unless the sides leave from the pan, or you'll have a badly shaped dosa. Now this was the first one, so usually you cannot expect a perfect appam in the first try. So this is how you pour the batter, spread it over in such a way that the center is a bit thicker, and cover it. Cover the pan until the top portion of your appam is cooked and dry. It shouldn't be still battery. So once it's dry, you open it. The sides will be either a golden brown color, or just it will leave the sides of the pan. That's when you remove it, and you can even store it. If you want to reheat, you can steam it again and serve it with your stew or chutneys. So enjoy watching and do try it. Don't forget to press the notification button. Thanks friends. See you all soon again.